thing. Option individuals. Yeah. Got the original game went right into a cutscene. Disney. THQ Nordic. Classic. Purple lamp. Well, they had a lot of teams working on this, huh?
A long time ago.
Oh, this looks good. I don't know if it's just me, but it looks slightly claymation-esque. Oh.
I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious. Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project. Touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten.
Beautiful.
Satisfied with my progress, I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers.
This does look really good. And again, I don't know if it's just me, but it kind of looks claymation-esque a bit for some reason.
Paint, brush, and thinner.
Might just be me. I wonder if they'll have the Alice in Wonderland world actually a part of this now. Maybe not. Could they still take it out? Or do they?
I heard the noises.
Yes, yes, they do.
I rushed to see what had happened, but I was too late. The world I had created was ravaged, a wasteland. The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
Look at all that history. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh, gorgeous. Whoop. Ain't playing that. G'day time, my fuzzyites. Welcome to Epic Mix Mickey Rebrushed Demo. I had recently gotten through all of the Epic Mickey on Wii. And now it's time to check out the demo. I played the Epic Mickey on Wii because the demo. That sounds low. Why is that low? Oh. And now the demo's coming out. So I decided to take a look, because I'm definitely going to buy the game myself when the time comes. But I want to check it out, because I'm going to play the demo, and when the game comes out, I won't be playing that version of the game, as you'll have the demo to check out. And see, plus my own reactions to it. But, like, I highly recommend buying the game. The Wii version was just spectacular, and just getting an updated version is going to be amazing. I would love to do it if I had time to do a side-by-side comparison between the remake and this one, though I'm sure other people already have, if people are curious.
I'm out of here.
Lay gulp. Oh. Oh. Were they there in the original game? Scar, Maleficent, Mufasa on the wall? Or, Captain Hook.
Over here, Mickey!
I don't remember them. Missing some sound effects, I think. Oh, there's a dash now.
You're safe in this spot. This control panel can be damaged with your spin attack. There's a spin attack by pressing Y.
Nice that there's a dash attack now. Or dodge now. A little slow down.
When the control panel is broken, take care of this one.
Collecting is a lot quicker in this one. That's good. Oh! I gotta remember that B is not... a lot quicker. I like it. Oh, that actually has a stuffed duck in it now.
Now use the spin attack to break this one. Back over to this machine, Mickey. What? Why? Did I not? Okay, I hope sound effects are included in the final game. And they just didn't get them completed yet. Because this is... Redone revealed a secret room. There are more to explore it if you'd like. Yeah, there are some... There are seriously some, sound effects missing. So... before you buy it, I would... Wait to see if you care, to see if those are in or not. That's so weird for them not to include it. And that makes me very worried. Because if you're doing a demo, you want to have everything in the first, you know, part be... Nope, not that. Oh, look at that. Ooh, but better way to do the menuing. Batman. Extras right from this menu. 3 cartoons instead of 2. Ooh. Audio. Take it all the time. Dr. Lab. It does look better. A bronze pin.
Well done! This is a collectible pin, one of many you can find in the wasteland. Most of them are unique and commemorate special events and places. You can see how many you collect while you're here.
So yeah, they've already streamlined a lot of the stuff. There's a dash move now. Collecting things is a lot easier. Because you don't have to wait a second, which was always a pain in the Wii version. That's not good.
Be careful of the thunderpool. Remember that you can get hurt if you don't fall in.
So yeah, you can either attack that stuff or run into it with the dash, except for that. Only breakable stuff, I guess. I gotta remember that, B is dash, not jump. Because it's A to jump. Okay, whatever. I'm not gonna worry about e-tickets and whatnot right now.
Aww. I have to get back home.
Oh, they didn't do sound, full voice.
Please.
The shadow block. That thing is painted, made of paint and thinner.
But, let's see, I'm scared of this brush. Whoa! Wow!
That thinner dissolves everything painted.
Oh, I wonder what else a brush can do.
That's paint. It restores things dissolved by thinner. You're quite the artist.
Wonder if that'll have more of a play into things this time.
Well, you're full of surprises. Guess you soaked up some of the blot.
But I'm still me. Let's practice.
Press LZ thinner and hold down to use paint. LZ to use thinner.
Okay. Nice.
This corridor. It requires that will take us to Dark Disney Castle. Put the thunder out the gear and then hold RZ or ZR to paint. Rebrushed can thin out cartoon objects like the door frame. No. Can I change up the controls? Graphics. Input? No. Maybe the final game will have it. Oh, and the cutscenes we had there, oddly enough, look very similar, if just barely touched up, from the last, from the original Epic Mickey.
Don't forget that the cartoon can be restored with paint.
That looked weird.
Guys, right through that gate.
Yeah, probably not gonna worry about getting any of the collectibles. If I ever play this again, I'll have to redo it anyways.
There! Part of the Moth's Blotting Army.
Okay, I think they're a little bit touched up. Are they dangerous?
Oh, they're not good company. You can fight by using the R stick to aim with your target. At your target. For a friend, the coach will look like this. For our opponent, it'll look like this. You can fight blotlings in two ways. Hit them with thinner to thin them out, or hit them with paint to turn them friendly. Many opponents are stunned when you jump on their heads. Each time an opponent is hits you, you'll lose a life. Lose all your pips and you're done. The Sheer is only one type of foe. Many kinds are in the wasteland, but you'll find out about that soon enough. Hello. I got the Sheer saw you, Mickey. Looks like it's called a friend.
Oh, it's heart, not Mickey Mouse things. Aww. You can go up that way too. Could you always go up this way and I just didn't notice? Maybe it was. Maybe they made it more prominent here.
There's a pressure plate. Lower when you step on it. You can press pressure plates down faster by pressing X while in the air.
Ooh, a butt slam this time.
There's a spin gear. Interact with it. Remember that you can press Y to perform a spin attack. Oh, that's Kremlin Malvin. He'll be happy to get out of that cage. He looks mad enough to break that catapult. When you see other gremlins, try to help them. He's sure to be a friend. Hello. Careful, Mickey. That chest is sitting on a pressure plate. That'll fire this catapult if it's disturbed. Do you really want to choose treasure chests over the safety of a gremlin?
Kinda wish it was an air dash. But oh well.
Thank you, Mickey. I feared the worst when you died, Doctor, put me in that thing. Now, it won't endanger anyone else. Take this gold pin for freeing me.
Yeah. Besides the
thinner can remove toon blocks.
Smoother. Yeah, besides the machine, oddly enough, not having any sound effects, everything else seems good. Again, it's just weird putting out a demo and not having everything in said demo be really up to snuff. Because it just seems lazy or off for it not to have sound effects. And I hope that's not a thing in the final game. Or they never meant to put sound effects in, or it's been forgotten, but I'm sure other people on the internet have been like, hey, just so you know, you guys forgot to put sound effects for this thing. It's probably been mentioned many times. Stronger down in a better train. We'll find our way to the castle. Let's get a closer look. One thing I do know, I don't know if they're gonna add... Oh, that didn't take much. Didn't give much damage. That's good. If they're gonna add much in the way of, like, bonus levels... Oh, it's hearts now instead of the... Oh, I like the Mickey Mouse hearts. Ready to go into a projector? Yes. I went this way, but...
Turtles like this are how we get around Wasteland. The rabbit named Oswald. He set them up.
But a projector screen...
That's strange. Seems natural for cartoons.
Well, what's it for?
You just jump in. Get ready to jump.
Changed up the look of the reels as well, heavily. That gives a lot of... Feels like... Ooh. So yeah, they changed up some things as well from here. The attack in the air now does bring you up a little bit more. I think in the other game, it kind of just went flat along. Not much. Growing beanstalk. That's it. Weird, because it was the bed that would move last time. Oh, that hurt. So they probably redid a lot of these, things. For some reason. I mean, makes it more special and different, I guess. And I'm all for it. But yeah, like I was saying, I don't know if they're gonna add anything really new world-wise. Two reels. Okay.
We have to go to Slalom.
Something funny is afoot. I know they have costumes, apparently. There's costumes you can get for the game now to change Mickey's look. Which is fun referencing his past works and whatnot.
Hey, Gremlin. Daisto, what are you doing, Daisto?
I guess someone sabotaged the door. I'm gonna fix it with paint.
That's an impressive door. Definitely Gremlin construction. Hey, Mickey, can you give us a hand by throwing paint around?
That'd be great. I'll be working on that middle gear, so don't break it, please. Hello! It's fixed.
Oh no. Those are nasty things near back there. The pipe isn't thinned out. Let's get it. Don't touch the steam or you'll be knocked back.
Thank you for your help. Only someone with the unique talent of creating paint can have done it. I'll meet you further down the line. I'm sure of it.
So the sound effects seem a little loud.
There it is again. We should be able to go this way too. Just watch your step. Thinner, get through there. The thinner, that big gear. Then the big gear, or paint over that one other thing. There we go, 5 of 5. Or step, try using a double jump to reach the platform. Okay.
So they have changed some of the layout, because I think we were lower. No, maybe not. I don't know. It's been a while since I replayed the beginning part of this game.
Right, that's not supposed to seal unless there's an emergency. This is a trap. Someone shut the door.
Oh, they have little ears. Mickey Mouse ears now. Did they have that before? No, I'm second guess everything about myself.
Hey, that's bladder beat. Beat it, Mickey. Give it what for? Now the problem, the exit has been closed. Let's go clear the path. Let me clear the plastic collectible for you. Enjoy.
Hold it now, Oswald. Could have set some traps.
You get massive height in this game now. Again, there's an absence of things.
You've attracted a guardian, Mickey.
Some sound effects.
The guardians are attracted and help you along your way. Press R to race to the nearest opponent. Oh wait, there's more. Pressing R to launch. Hold R to launch all your guardians. Trips will be timed, and this will do the same, but with paint. A guardian used in either way will do stuff.
That looks more teacup-y now. With an actual teapot on top. Nice.
It looks like the Gremlin Tempest trapped in the ticket booth by Blotlings.
Hey. Hey, get over there. Deal with these creatures. They have me trapped here, please.
There we go.
Alright, Splatters, just because Mickey went easy doesn't mean I will beat it.
Let's start the boats. And now you can jump on them at any time. help you in several ways. In fact, more like painting or thinning the world around you. The bar at the bottom level will show you what you're about to attach. Guardians. Each segment of the bar you complete attracts a new one. The guardians are just to help you, Mickey. Why is it? Why is anyone's guess? I do like it. Again, it's weird. It's just missing some sound effects. Which might be one of the last things you do in a creation type thing. Some sound effects, but they got a lot of the majority of them. Alright, enough looking around. So yeah, they changed up some things. They adjusted some things. Changed looks around. This looks really nice. I like how it's now a thing. Should I help him or no? Oh, let's help him.
Hey, bossing, I'm riding, Mickey. I'd love to start the ride, but it seems the machinery is broken. I need my wrench. Working near the spinning teacups with the red stripe on top of it. It's out of the deck. Haven't seen it since. Well, if you're willing to help, it's near the machine, near the elephant ride. I'll be near the machine, near the elephant ride.
With the red stripe. Let's take it to Gremlin Chain at the elephant ride. Nope. Sorry.
My wrench! Now I can fix the broken elephant ride machine.
I wonder if the full game will have motion control as well. Because while I don't overly like motion control all the time, I do think it's a fun thing to have in case you're feeling up to it.
Now the bikes behind the maintenance wall are leaking. That's my guess. Non-flying types like you can use the elephant ride to get up to the big tent. Over there, you can reach the maintenance area. It's a difficult path, but I'm sure you seem capable. If you need me, I'll be behind the spinning teacup ride. Okay, we aren't going to do any more with this.
Yeah, same missions as always. Oh, what? Oh, look at that. Doing random things in the environment give you random rewards. That's nice. There are now invisible... Ah, screw it, let's just go. Oh. Yep. I forgot about that. Oh, the paint thinner stand-in machine. You fill with either paint or thinner, but never both at the same time. Paint often fixes things like rut, getting the ride smoother. Thinner tends to throw a wrench into the works. Sometimes that's handy, though. A paint thinner machine is always connected to something. This one is connected to the spinning cup ride, in case it's connected by pipes. To repair the ride, patch the pipes and see the pump. Remember, though, filling it up with thinner may have unexpected consequences. First pipe, now you need to fill the pump.
It's right now, it makes me feel better. In fact, so much better that I can open this door for you. Please keep whatever you find in there, along with my gratitude.
Silver pin. We go. Now we're just gonna hurry up and just go to the end.
Well, this ride isn't repaired at all. Almost jammed up here. Some have rammed and overturned. The door should be automatically opened, but I guess it's broken too. There are pipes inside the walls that operate the door's locks. Thinning them out, the pipes will break the locks and the door will open. Now that I think about it, the hippos are connected to the wall as well. Stopping the hippos from with paint will bypass the doors locked and should open too. Every choice has two choices. Oh, that's thinner. Ain't you adorable?
Nice elephant door. That's it? Really? You're kidding. I'm actually very surprised. I thought we'd go at least until, the Gremlin Village or something like that, fight the boss, but, oh, if I knew it was this short, would have gone around a lot more. Let's check the eShop. Hide stuff just in case there's stuff people don't need to see. Guess the putting in the passcode. I thought there'd be a lot more than that. Ugh. Oh, I'm on the wrong. Yeah, never mind. Pink Fuzzies is different. But yeah, I guess that's the demo. A very, very, very short experience. Sucks. I would have wished you got further in, at least give to Gremlin Village, where you have the choice of either, like, helping or hindering Pete and whatnot. Because, yeah, this is a lot shorter than I thought it was. Like, it's... Yeah. I don't know. Oh. There we go. Now you can hear. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I guess work on stuff after this. But anyways, that's it. That's all. Thank you, my fellas, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this very quick demo. Again, I wish it would have gone a little further to either getting to Main Street or getting to the Gremlin Village. But, yeah. Overall, it's missing some sound effects, which concerns me. But at the same time, that might not have been a main concern of the people. But at the same time, if you're doing a demo, you want to make sure everything is on point as possible. So that people know exactly what they're getting into. Because what this feels like to me right now is that the game is just going to miss sound effects that are obvious, that like obvious sound effects, and that concerns me about it. But like I said before, I will be playing this, or I will be buying it, getting it on my own, and whatnot. So check Animal Crossing, and I'll show you a few days after release on the 24th or whatever. But yeah, okay, that was Epic Mickey Rebrushed. It looks really good. I like the look of it. They changed up some really good things and whatnot. The sound effects is the only thing that makes me worry, but I'm sure it just wasn't the main concern. But again, the problem is, when you're doing a demo, you want to make sure that at least everything in the demo is up to snuff. Either way, thank you, my fellas, for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next anytime. Take care.